If you monkeys would consider upgrading your bodies with technology, it'd make my job a lot easier.
Yeah, because what's more appealing than a cold, heartless exterior wrapped around a cold, heartless interior?
I'm surprised you'd even know what a heart is, Wolf, with your cereal box PhD.
The day people find your Edward Scissorhands more inviting than my all-natural musk is the day this coffee enema drips out of my type.
Where am I? David? Is that you?
I gotta say thanks, Food Babe. I feel a lot better about myself knowing that you were annihilated by a clown in a Speedo.
The good news is you're alive. Bad news, so is that dinosaur.
Ugh, that disgusting blue lizard. I'm going back to Earth and mashing his tenders.
Hey, I already had dibs on him first. You saw him laser off my gorgeous Jufro. I'm gonna make him pay.
And how do you plan to make him pay without your powers?
Deepak, I asked you a million times, why can't we just go back to the future to get my healing crystal? I may not know how vaccines work, but I think I've got time travel down pat.
You think that time travel is just a trip to Whole Foods and back, do you? I am not one of your customers. I should not have to pay for your laziness and incompetence. And you, Food Babe, killed by a clown wearing a Speedo.
It's even better when he says it.
Shut your dear dick-munching pie hole.
There is no force in the universe stronger than the regret I have for putting faith in the two of you. I'm sending Agent Geller.
Yuri, the spoon-bending guy?
Well, that's just great, boss. Send in the kids' party entertainment. Are you fucking insane?
For all bungnose, you two are dead. Let's keep it that way.
Clara is right. Yuri Geller has one of the most powerful crystals in the organization. If God smiles down on our mission, we will have our prehistoric heretic burned by sunrise.
I had that dream again where I was drowning. It's been happening a lot more lately.
Perhaps it's a metaphor for your overwhelming obsession with furbies.
No, that'd be too obvious. It has to be something deeper.
Have you considered taking up sport?
What are you trying to say?
Nothing. I'm just trying to say that your mental health could be drastically improved by—
Are you calling me fat?
Well, that's very unprofessional of you, Doctor. Are you wearing my sweater?
What if I am, Doc? What if I am?
If I can fit this sweater, what's that say about you? You fat fuck!
Give that back!
No! Unhand me, you unoriginal
very childish!
I bet you can't even speak German! I'm so lonely!
Perhaps your dream is an emotional manifestation from feeling the pressure of your social life suffocating you.
Oh, haha, very funny.
That's not what I meant. I was implying that your refusal to socialize with others is causing you to disconnect with yourself, and therefore sinking you into an abyss of despair.
You might be onto something, Doctor.
If this be the case, I urge you to go out into the world and open up to others. Meet old friends, make new ones. Choose to break out of your bleak, soulless shell. Challenge yourself. Thrust your mind into the unknown. Let every fiber of your being be unwoven by the raw intensity of chance.
Or I could get a pet. That'll do.
Playing with myself. When there's nothing to lose except a gallon of booze, I'll be playing. What is your favorite movie that you can watch on both Halloween and Christmas time that came out in 1993? That's right, The Nightmare Before Christmas. Here at Nightmare Before Christmas Store, that's all we sell.
Tonight, on another episode of Detective Fat vs. the Sexually Inappropriate Nazis.
Oh, Detective Fat, you have fallen into my trap once again.
You will not get away with this, Hilda von Kruger. For as long as good fights on, evil will never triumph.
Once I press this trigger, Moscow, London, Paris, and Washington will go up in flames. Unless he eats his food, big boy.
I beg your pardon. I'm afraid I'm already in a committed relationship with justice.
Oh, but can justice do this?
Nah, not really.
Oh, I hate Remix.
Sorry about that. Updates are pain in the butt!
I know, Michael Fassbender was not meant for this role.
Why is the living room full of Furbies?
They're the only things that don't leave me.
Why are there claw marks on the roof?
Raccoons and hawks really hate each other.
This.
Now that's a good question.
I should have known you'd refuse to wear your visor when I was gone.
It's not like I'm doing anything today. I was looking for a pet.
Why don't you hang around those guys you met at the Halloween party you went to?
Oh yeah, Walter and Jermaine. Those synth pop guys, yeah? Or electro pop, I can't remember.
You probably would have remembered that if you wore your visor this morning. How often do you keep in touch with your friends?
Well, I talk to you every day, so I'm pretty sure you count as a friend.
Aww.
I guess you're more of an appliance, you know, like a toaster or a laptop, you know what I mean? You know, because you're a robot, so I don't know where to draw a line between a person and, like, a microwave when it comes to robots.
Well, I'm going back to updating because I'm a robot with no emotions at all.
Yo, what's up? Yo, what's up?
Hello, hello. You've reached the Megaweed Tour Bus.
Walter Pendleton speaking.
And Jermaine Chamberlain driving.
Walter, hi, it's Bung. That dinosaur, that Halloween party.
Oh, hey, Bung. When did I give you my number?
Sometime between Evil Dead Marathon and Sex Change Prank.
I remember that, because I texted you photos after the party of my brother screaming in the mirror.
I'd smash those milk jugs, like a farmer with Parkinson's.
That's inappropriate.
So what have you guys been up to?
Well, we spent most of our tour money renting out cinemas, which in 2016 comedy movies.
We wanted to not laugh in silence.
So we're heading to Vegas to celebrate.
What were you celebrating, might I ask?
Got myself an act in the MGM Grand Casino.
That's great. That's incredible. Listen. I know you must be pretty busy and I don't want to waste your time, but...
Bung, mate. Say no more.
There's always room for one more brother in the Megaweeds tour bus.
Sir, the dinosaur. He is entering the Vegas realm.
Find him. Bring him to me, and I'll break him.
And that's how I'm able to afford a house and food.
Oh, it all makes sense now.
My thirst for knowledge has been quenched.
Bung, mate, why didn't you invite that marina girl to Vegas with you?
She said she wanted to travel the world, do things she's never got to do, all that kind of stuff.
Ah, yeah.
Sometimes she'll send me a photo of a cat she wants to kill.
Fair enough. Hey, Jermaine, say that last thing you said.
What? Why?
Just do it.
My thirst for knowledge has been quenched?
Wow. You know what I'm thirsting for, gents? Some Witch Doctor Malibu rum, please.
That took you a really long time to say.
And what about you, Dinosaur Man?
Pomegranate martini, please.
The gayest drink in the known multiverse.
Do I know you?
You didn't see this face.
Walter, trance musicians, 9 o'clock.
Why are they frowning at us?
I'd need psych strong if I had to listen to Discount Nightcore all day.
Okay, Synthes, that's a bit transphobic.
Genuine question. How many of your listeners are weeaboos?
How many of your listeners are over 60?
Got him.
Now tell me, does your manager pay you in hair gel or galaxy t-shirts?
You leave galaxy shirts out of this!
Dude, calm down.
The Dance Dance Revolution machine is that way, lads.
Wait, there's a difference between trance music and synth pop?
I'm going to pretend I didn't hear that.
That's like asking what's the difference between a dog and a much better sounding dog.
As Nietzsche once said, synth pop is the opium of the people.
And what's a party without some?
No, Jermaine, that was just an analogy.
No, this is ecstasy.
No, that's a metaphor.
What did I just say?
Jermaine, where did you get that?
A friend.
Adam.
Molly.
We are not taking drugs.
It's buttons anywhere.
You're all killing my buzz. You two, do what you've got to do to have a good time.
So what's it like being a talking dinosaur?
Well, I mean, it's like being a person, but with less hat options, I guess. I'm so sorry. Hold on. Oh, much better.
Are you all right?
Oh, perfectly fine. So what's there to do in Vegas?
Oh, man. You know that guy, Chris Angel?
Oh, God, yeah.
We're seeing him tomorrow. I hope we get to see that trick where he pulls a dove out of his liver.
Oh, God. Or the one where he takes his spine out and plays Jenga? I wish I had his abilities.
Abilities? Surely you mean you wish you knew how to do his tricks.
Oh dear, we have a cynic.
Cynic alert!
Cynic alert!
Excuse me? I'm sorry, but how is it cynical to say that his tricks can be learned? That's just a fact. You don't really think he... you don't really think he has magical powers, do you?
Whoa!
Again... How am I cynical for acknowledging that magic isn't-
Oh come on, how else does he know which card is yours on his show every time? Every single time!
You could just edit out all the times he gets the trick wrong.
Whoa! Cynic alert!
Hey, I'm not saying that's what he does, I'm just saying it's an easy trick to achieve with editing, especially since it's not really that impressive.
Dude!
Okay, I'm sorry, do you really believe he has supernatural powers? Are you serious? If that asshole actually had the ability to tear open his scrotum to release bats into the night sky, then don't you think he could be saving lives with his reality-bending ability instead of performing on stage? Have you lost it? But why is it suddenly cynical of me to expect grown adults to think like grown adults? Now, I'm not trying to be rude, but fuck you!
Oh... my god.
I was considering telling a joke about a man who finds a magic lamp in the desert, but now I'm worried you two will hurl yourself off the fucking roof of this hotel the moment I even insinuate my position on the existence of genies.
Bong, where's your chill?
I'm chill, I'm perfectly chill. Yeah, just talking with some nice people.
Mate, something's wrong. Maybe you need to get something from the snack bar.
Didn't we bring those Toblerones?
Well, I asked Jermaine to bring them, but he hasn't come back.
This dinosaur is a strong foe. Doubt has always been his ally. Years of public ridicule will turn into a faint memory once the titanium in his bloodstream is completely wiped from the face of existence. The eye will prevail.
Oh, Christ. Cake, can you give me a hand here?
Oh, I'm sorry. A simple malfunction. I am nothing more than an accessory, after all.
You're still mad about that, aren't you?
Terrific observation.
When we get home, I'm uninstalling your sass.
I believe we haven't met, Lord Bung.
No, I'm well acquainted with the moon.
We are from the Union of American Mediums and Psychics.
Now that's a joke. Okay.
We are not here to fight, my sweet dinosaur friend. We are here with an offer from the Great One, our psychic lord!
Charles Xavier.
Uri Geller, the greatest bender of spoons in the known multiverse!
He seeks audience with you. You're invited to his penthouse suite in the Luxor Hotel.
Fuck no.
Excuse me?
Uri Geller, the guy that perpetuates the idea that there are people on this planet who can talk to the dead just to make a quick buck off of grieving families. Not a fan. No need to tell him I said that. I'm sure he can pick up my bad juju from a mile away. He's had every chance to prove everyone that he has otherworldly powers, but he confines these instances to learnable parlor tricks.
So much negativity.
Geller has powers beyond your comprehension. You are looking at the world through a pinhole.
Am I seriously being lectured by cult members on open-mindedness? Bending an already bent spoon on TV is not telekinesis.
Long May, I found some extra mittens in the barbecue cabinet. Why have you got your buzzkill glasses on?
I'm sorry, have we met?
Yes, I'm well acquainted with the moon.
I already made that joke.
Fuck, okay, give me a second.
Enough! You're coming with us to the penthouse suite, even if it means you're coming in a sword box.
It's actually really safe in there, just slightly uncomfortable. You will rue this day. You have blasphemed against the Great One!
The Union of American Mediums and Psychics. Fucking losers.
Wait, what?
The thing, I could have met Uri Geller. Except I didn't want to. Because he sucks.
Bung.
Yeah?
I've got to tell you something here.
What is it?
You know that job opportunity I was talking about?
No.
Yeah.
I thought it was a music gig.
I've always felt like I had some sort of ability.
You think you're a psychic?
Uri Geller called me a week ago. And said that I had something special. Something unique. A power.
Walter, you're not a psychic.
Bung, you don't know how many people I can help. I want to be a good person, and this is my chance to—
A chance to what? Take advantage of grieving widows for attention and boatloads of money? Psychics are not real.
What if you're wrong?
What if I'm wrong? What if you're wrong? It'll be much worse for you if you're wrong. You'd be taking part in one of the biggest scams on Earth. It's fucking—
What if you're wrong?
Okay. Let's entertain the idea of psychics being real for a minute then. If you're right, and a select few just so happen to have the ability to talk to the dead, see the future, why is it that they can't predict major accidents, war, natural disasters, or collect information from the dead to help solve a crime? Why is it that in this hypothetical world where people with godlike power exist, they selfishly use it solely for their own financial advantage? Sylvia Brown, James Prah, John Edwards, Uri Geller, people who make money from false hope. Walter, did you even think about this? You are so reckless.
And you're extremely uptight. You have no idea how to relax, do you? You're like a robot. You know how awkward you were 5 minutes ago when you heard of that sweet couple? What was that about? I thought that if I brought you here, you'd learn how to switch off, but you do nothing but kill the mood and pull me down. If I'm wrong, then I'm wrong, but let me find out for myself. And if you truly believe you're right, then at least you could take pleasure in the idea of me failing.
I fucked up today. I should have just stayed home. How so? I yelled at people for making decisions that ultimately don't affect me. And that makes me feel like a selfish asshole who just likes to argue with people for the sake of it. Oh please, you're too much of a pussy to enjoy arguments. Thanks. What was your intent behind the argument with that lovely couple?
They were annoying, didn't like how proud they were of being stupid. While most people may empathize with you, it is still unwarranted, even by your standards. Now what about Walter? I just didn't want him to become a psychic. And a psychic in your eyes is a terrible person, yeah?
Yeah.
And Walter is a friend, yeah?
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
Does caring for a friend sound selfish to you? He is a dreamer, and you are a realist. You two will always see each other as too cynical or too optimistic.
You might have a point there.
You know what to do.
There's no reality, just this world of illusion that keeps on haunting me. I am the Mind Freak! Mind Freak!
Oh hey, you're William?
Ah, Walter, actually. Are you Chris Angel?
Fuck yeah, dude. Just got back from tearing my scrotum open and releasing bats into the night sky. I'm sensing that you're here for a great purpose.
Yeah, I'm here to see...
You're here to see... Yuri Geller.
Hey, golf ball. What hotel did you say Yuri Geller was staying at?
The Luxor Hotel.
Thank you.
Why are you finally converting?
No.
Darn.
Excuse me, did you see a lanky pale emo with an outdated fashion sense?
I saw two, they were heading to the top floor.
Oh shit, this isn't good.
You're telling me, fucking queers. This used to be a classy city with good, honest gambling.
I will now grant you the power of the cosmos to be held at your fingertips.
Will it hurt?
Eh.
Walter, oh shit. Walter, you're right. I do have a hard time switching off. But I said what I said because I wanted to protect you, not because I wanted to prove you wrong. Not that anyone's counting, but that's 2 points for me.
Thanks for your assistance, Walter. But I just needed Mr. Bum.
Wait, what?
Welcome.
What do you want with me?
You, Lord Bung, represent a strong part of my history that shaped me who I am today. Unfortunately, it was a very bad part of my history.
Bend a spoon in your asshole, you money hunter. Cake?
Yeah, I got over what you said. I know you didn't mean it.
Cake, I want you to know that I do appreciate...
Shut up. We don't need two gay-ass speeches in this video. Let's just beat this asshole and save your stoner friend. How often do you keep in touch with your friends?
Kill me. Pull me down.
Cynical alert. Cynical alert.
Your refusal to socialize with others is causing you to disconnect with yourself and sinking you into an abyss of
stress. That's like asking what's the difference between a dog and a much better sounding dog.
You're the only other dinosaur on the planet, and you're a fruit
of the forest. The mighty Spakatum will bend to the winds of change.
Honey, I'm home!
Hey kids, how you doing? What a lovely normal life I have.
You're not my wife!
Walter? What is this?
Yuri explained everything to me. He has this advanced crystal technology from the future that allows him to do this weird shit he does and trapping us inside our minds. Guess you were right. Psychics aren't real, and even though Yuri has this advanced ability, he still uses it for selfish purposes. I just wanted to know things for once. I guess I thought being a psychic, I could finally find a reason to be happy. Wouldn't you want to have something like that, even if it does sound ridiculous?
Yeah, that'd be nice. Alright, come on, let's go.
Huh?
There are just some things nobody will ever know. The best part about that is that we're all in it together.
I'll take that over crippling loneliness and Seinfeld reruns.
Good. Now we're about to do something reckless. When I'm back in my body, I'll wake you up, we get the crystal, and defeat Yuri.
Now how are you gonna wake up?
Clear!
Where's Yuri?
I have no idea. He just left.
He can't have gone far.
No, but you've gone far enough.
Okay.
You like magic tricks, huh?
No.
Let's do that Penn and Teller catch a bullet in your mouth magic trick then.
Chris, you don't have to do this.
Oh, but Bung, it is my job description to blow people's minds.
Fuck! Fucking hell! Oh,
oh
my god.
God, dude, I'm so sorry.
That's my synthesizer
I'll
hand.
Go get some ice. Wait one second.
my plan all along, that one.
Congratulations, you've escaped the dream realm. However, once the Luxor Hotel's dropped from a high enough altitude, I bet you and your friends probably would have wished you did.
This is just like Age of Ultron.
I don't understand your reference.
I envy you.
You cannot stop us, Mr. Bung. You cannot stop the future.
Well, tell the future to go back to the future. Give me time to think. Oh, how did you do that?
I've got you!
When the police show up, we just blame ISIS, alright?
Oh my god, you're safe.
Most of him.
Fucking hell. Vegas really is a dump.
Where have you been?
I don't really know, and I'm not too happy about it.
This is the third nut job with a crystal who tried to kill you over the past 2 months. What do you think that means?
You think it might be some big conspiracy?
All I know is that these crystals are from the future and they're very, very powerful. Which is why I think you should hold on to it.
What? Me?
Because if there are any more of these guys looking for me, at least they won't be able to find the crystal. Also, free superpowers.
Oh, hell yeah.